recently got this book in the mail. I didn't order it or anything. It just came in the mail addressed to current resident. I guess it's like a free promo. The title is Changed. It's supposedly a true story, an autobiography, about a man who went from being, in his words, lost and defiled to found and cleansed. His name is Tom Cantor, and as you can probably already tell, he's a Jesus freak. This story explains how he became one after being raised in a strong culture of Judaism, which he only went along with because his parents made him. He basically went from one religion to another, which isn't surprising considering the fact that his own autobiography makes him look like an idiot. On summer break from boarding school, he met a few hoes, you know, and willingly had sex with them, then felt so guilty and ashamed. He actually thought about committing suicide. His fiance told him she's pregnant with another man's baby. Not because she cheated, she claims, but because she was raped. Even though she didn't bother to tell him about the pregnancy or the rape until he proposed to her months later. And he just believed her. He gets so distraught and depressed about his now wife's alleged rape, not to mention all the evil sex that he had before he married her, that he desperately cries out for help. And guess who he cries out to?
He cried out to God.
But first, he's gotta find him. On the first day of my search for God, I sat at a table after work with that big Bible in front of me. Without opening it, I just sat there staring at its cover. I had never read a book with that many pages before. With dyslexia, I was never a reader. By the time I graduated from high school, the largest book I had ever read had 100 pages, and that about killed me. But in front of me now was a book that had about 2,000 pages. I thought about how hard it was going to be if I had to read through 2,000 pages to find God. But I knew I was at the end of my rope. It was my last chance in life to find relief. I had only one choice left. I had to search for God in the Bible. All he's doing is reinforcing the doctrine he was born into, grew up doubting, and never got smart enough to fully think his way out of. That there exists a magical God that relieves all suffering. Not because you've actually seen this God or anything like that, but because a book says so.